بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله. Respected brothers and sisters and honorable listeners, we're continuing with our lectures, our Ramadan reminders on the virtues and blessings and obligations of the Quran. And tonight, inshallah, we are going to be discussing the fact that the Quran is afdhalu dhikr. The Quran is the most virtuous of means by which we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I will be reading tonight from a book, and actually this is the muqaddimah and the introduction to the tafsir of Imam al-Qurtubi. And this is by Imam al-Qurtubi himself, At-Tidhkar fi Afdalil Adhkar. It's the actual title of this introduction is a reminder in regards to the most virtuous of all remembrances. In other words, that the Qur'an al-Kareem is the most virtuous and the most superior way of remembering Allah Azza wa Jal. And there's a very interesting story or incident, we can say, that is narrated by Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, or regarding Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Imam Qurtubi mentions that ruwiya an Ahmad ibn Hanbal, or an Ahmad ibn Hanbal radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, annahu qal, ra'aytu rabbil izza fil manam. فقلت يا رب ما أفضل ما يتقرب به المتقربون إليك يا رب ما أفضل ما يتقرب به المتقربون إليك. Imam Ahmad radiyallahu anhu, may Allah be pleased with him, said that I saw my Lord in a dream. And the meaning of that is what? Seeing Allah in a dream. In other words, you feel in your heart that, you know, a vision, right? A vision that there is a presence, and you feel in your heart that this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't literally mean that you are seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, it's a presence that you feel that this is Allah azza wa jal. So he says, I seen Allah azza wa jal in this vision. And I asked, oh my Lord, what is the best and the most virtuous and superior way that those who draw near to you and those who come near to you, they come near to you? Yani, what is the best way by which people come near to you and people get close to you? And remember, when we're talking about nearness and closeness to Allah, we're not talking about physical closeness. Rather, we are speaking about the proximity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? We're talking about coming close to Allah ta'ala, yani achieving the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and attaining the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this in reality is the meaning of the qurb of Allah Azza wa Jal, yani attaining the love of Allah, attaining the pleasure of Allah, attaining the proximity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ma'iyat, and you know, the fact that when we're doing that, Allah ta'ala's pleasure and Allah's blessings and Allah's mercy is upon us in a special form. So he asks, what is the way, the best way that a person can draw near to you and attain your proximity? فقال, yani Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, كلامي يا أحمد. It is through my words, yani through my kalam, through my words, through the Quran, O Ahmad. فقلت يا رب بفهم أو بغير فهم. O my Lord, by understanding or without understanding its meanings. Is it by understanding the meaning or without understanding the meaning? فقال, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered, بفهم وبغير فهم. By understanding its meaning and without understanding its meaning, a person will achieve the dhikr of Allah and achieve the proximity and closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala either way. وَنُقِلَ هَذَا الرُّؤْيَا عَنْهُ وَنَقَلَ هَذَا الرُّؤْيَا عَنْهُ كِبَارُ الْعُلَمَاءِ. And Imam al-Qurtubi authenticates this, that senior ulama and very great ulama have narrated this story and attributed it to Imam Ahmad. But what a beautiful thing that we are learning from this is when we, brothers and sisters, want to achieve that nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we want to achieve that closeness to Allah. A lot of times a person, you know, we want to do something. We want to achieve closeness. We want to achieve this relationship and connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, there is nothing which is more virtuous and more superior and the best means by which we attain that closeness to Allah except by His book. So let us in this Mubarak month, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, that this is the month of the Qur'an, let us in this month make a commitment and make a regimen of daily recitation of the Qur'an. However much we can do, build a connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this month through His book. Subhanallah. Another very beautiful thing that's mentioned, قال سفيان الثوري رضي الله تعالى عنه أن سمعنا أن قراءة القرآن أفضل الذكر إذا عمل به. Sufyan al-Thawri, who was one of the great scholars of Islam, and he was from the Salaf, from the pious predecessors in the early centuries, he says that we have heard, and when Sufyan al-Thawri says we have heard, it will most definitely be from the Tabi'een and those who have heard it from the Sahaba. سمعنا أن قراءة القرآن, that we have heard that the recitation of the Qur'an is أفضل الذكر. It is the most virtuous and superior remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's many ways that we can remember Allah. We can remember Allah through dua, right? We can make dua. We can make, remember Allah through la ilaha illallah and astaghfirullah and subhanallah and alhamdulillah. And we could do, various different actions by which we, attain Allah ta'ala's remembrance. But in reality here, Sufyan Thawri rahimahullah is saying that we have heard this, and obviously this will go back to the early Salaf from amongst the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, that the most virtuous of the dhikrs, the most virtuous means by which Allah Ta'ala is remembered, is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here, Imam Al-Qurtubi narrates a statement from Hakim Al-Tirmidhi, saying that we have not understood this statement, that the Qur'an is the most superior means of remembering Him. He said, if we truly ponder, that one is the way that we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الذكر هو شيء يبتدعه العبد من تلقاء نفسه من علمه بربه. That when we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, we make dua, oh Allah ta'ala, you are the most merciful. Oh Allah ta'ala, you are the most forgiving. Forgive my sins. Oh Allah, pardon me. Oh Allah, you are the most kind. Oh Allah, shower your kindness upon me. So these words that we recite in Allah ta'ala's remembrance, and these words that we make dua to Allah through them, right? In reality, these words are what? This is from our own side, right? We are saying these words. We are uttering these words, right? These words are created words. These words are words that we concoct them, and we read them and we say them. But the Quran, huwa shay'un qad takallama bihi ar-rabb tabaaraka wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. But the Quran, these are the words that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself from pre-eternity had uttered these words. And those words were preserved on the Lawh-e Mahfuz, the preserved tablet. And those words were then transferred to the heart of Jibreel alayhi salam, who then brought it upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and the letters and the words and the ayat and the surahs that we now recite is a direct connection. And when we recite these words directly take us to what is the uncreated actual kalam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And obviously the Quran, which is the words and the sentences that we have here, right? These words that we recite is not the exact spoken direct word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is connected to Allah ta'ala's that. However, when we recite it, it takes us back directly to Allah azza wa jal. And I'll give an example. When we are reciting the Quran and we're reciting these words, it is very similar to when you dial a phone number that is directly connected to a specific individual. For example, Zayd. When I dial Zayd's number, right, I go to my contacts, I go to Z, and then there's a number, 510-565-1234. And then I dial that number, Zayd. That specific number goes directly and connects you to Zayd himself. So brothers and sisters, when we are reciting the Quran, these words that we recite, this is like that phone number that directly takes us back and connects us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like when you make a text message, just like when you make a phone call, that specific number will take you directly to, right, that person or that contact. Similarly, these words that we have in Kitabullah, these words that we have in the Qur'an Kareem, right? These words are the direct words and take us to that direct kalam of Allah Azza wa Jal. When we recite these words, when we recite kalamullah, it is as if we're dialing and it takes us directly to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the pre-eternal word of Allah Azza wa Jal. These words in the Quran make dalalat to those pre-eternal words. Subhanallah, I mean, it's almost unfathomable. It's almost, you know, unbelievable. So when we recite it, فَإِذَا تَلَاهُ الْعَبْدِ فَإِنَّمَا يَتَكَلَّمُ بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَانَ عِنْدَ الرَّبِّ سُبْحَانُهُ وَتَعَالَى. When we're reciting it, we're actually reciting something that had emanated from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. وَلَمْ يَخْلُقْ مُنْذُ نَزَلَ إِلَى الْعَبْدِ وَلَا يَخْلُقْ وَلَا يَتَدَنَّسْ فَهُوَ عَلَى طَرَاوَتِهِ وَطِيبِهِ وَطَهَارَتِهِ وَلَهُ كِسْوَةٌ. And these words, because they come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself, right? It has this freshness, and it has this sweetness, and it has this, it's enveloped with a very special mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالذِّكْرُ الَّذِي يَذْكُرُهُ الْعَبْدُ مُبْتَدِعًا مِنْ عِنْدِ نَفْسِهِ لَا كِسْوَةَ لَهُ. And when a person is, you know, remembering Allah with his own words, such as saying, oh Allah, you are the most merciful, and oh Allah, you are the most kind, and you know, you're saying, Allah, forgive my sins, and you're remembering him with your own words that you have, you have devised from your own self. Then what is this? This does not have that connection to the divine and to the pre-eternal word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَيْضًا هُوَ الَّذِي يُؤَلِّفُ الْعَبْدُ وَلَيْسَ أَعْلَمُ لِأَنَّهُ مُشْتَمِلٌ على جميع الذكر من تهليل وتذكير وتحميد وتسبيح وتمجيد. And he continues to say, and when we are putting words together, this is from us. But when you read the Quran also has La ilaha illallah in it. Like we should recite La ilaha illallah from ourselves. But the Quran, when you recite it, the Quran also has Subhanallah. يُسَبِّحُ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. So many surahs. Alhamdulillahi فاطر السماوات والأرض. Right? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Right? تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير. So it has, tasbih, and it has tahmid, and it has takbir, right? And it has the glorification of Allah, right? And it has du'as, right? ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة. This is from the Quran. So the Quran has du'a, the Quran has la ilaha illallah, the Quran has استغفار وقل رب اغفر وارحم وأنت خير الراحمين. The Quran has all the words. It has istighfar in it. It has subhanallah in it. It has la ilaha illallah in it. It has, right? Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala al-Nabi. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu. Wa salamun ala al-mursaleen. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifoon. Wa salamun ala al-mursaleen. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. It's sending salutations on the prophets. And it's glorification. And it's, praise. And it is seeking forgiveness. And it is prayers, and it is du'as, and it is seeking protection from the hellfire. And all of these blessed things are contained within the Qur'an in and of itself. Also, it has, lessons and teachings and commandments and halal and haram and guidance, right? And it tells us about, the unseen, and it tells us about the akhirah, and it gives us prophecies about what is yet to come. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself says, مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. We have not left out from this book anything. فَمَنْ وَقَفَ عَلَى ذَلِكَ وَتَدَبَّرَهُ فَقَدْ حَصَّلَ أَفْضَلَ الْعِبَادَاتِ. And if a person ponders over this, that Allah says, مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ, we have not left out in the Quran anything, then he will realize that when he is reciting the Quran, then he is actually doing all of the dhikrs. He's actually doing all of those things of the righteous words that can be recited. All of the righteous words are contained in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَقَدْ حَصَّلَ أَفْضَلَ الْعِبَادَاتِ وَأَسْنَ الْأَعْمَالِ وَالْقُرُبَاتِ. When you recite the Quran, you have actually attained, right, the most virtuous of all worship, and the most superior of all actions, and means by which we draw near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَمْ يَبْقَ عَلَيْهِ مَا يُطَالِبُ بِهِ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. And after that, he is not required to do anything else after that, because when you're reciting the Quran, you have attained all of it. Subhanallah. And that is why, in one hadith narrated in Tirmidhi, on the authority of Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu anhu, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, يَقُولُ الرَّبُّ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. Allah Ta'ala Himself says, and it's a hadith Qudsi. Hadith Qudsi is that hadith which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions it with his word, but he attributes it to his Lord. يعني هو الكلام الذي يلفظه هو الكلام الذي يقوله النبي بلفظه وينسبه إلى ربه. It is the words that the Prophet ﷺ says with his tongue, but is actually, you know, the words from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that were inspired to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but not Quran. Right? These words aren't the Quran. So this hadith Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Man shaghalahu qira'atu al-Qur'ani an mas'alati." Anyone who the Quran occupies him from asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you have Kitabullah, yani the recitation of Quran. You have the recitation of Quran. And then you have, right, making dua. So you're so busy in the reciting of the Quran, and sometimes maybe even, you know, at suhoor time or at iftari time, you know, we're so busy reading the Quran at the time of iftar, you know, we want to finish our juz at that time, that we might not have time to make du'as at that particular juncture. So the one who's so busy in reciting the Quran, then what happens? مَنْ شَغَلَهُ قِرَاءَةُ الْقُرْآنِ and mas'alati, he who's so busy in reciting the Quran that he does not have time to make any du'as. Then what? أَعْطَيْتُهُ أَفْضَلَ مَا أُعْطِ السَّائِلِينَ. Then I will grant him, Allah says, I will give the person who is reciting Quran, I will give him better than what those people who are asking me. Subhanallah. قَالَ وَفَضْلُ كَلَامِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى عَلَى سَائِلِ الْكَلَامِ كَفَضْلِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى عَلَى خَلْقِهِ. And he said, the virtue of Allah Ta'ala's words over the words of creation is like the virtue of Allah over His creation. Right? What do you think is the virtue and the superiority of Allah over His creation? It's not even comparable. Right? It's not even comparable. فَلَا تَضْرِبُوا لِلَّهِ الْأَمْثَالِ. Don't even compare. Right? Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala in comparison to His creation, it's not even comparable. Therefore, Allah Ta'ala's words are not even comparable to any other words. Subhanallah. And how do we understand this? That the one who is so busy reciting the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him better than he gives those people who are asking. So Hazrat Shaykh Mawlana Zakariya rahmatullah alayhi, he gives a beautiful example. He said, imagine a person who is a servant, and you know, the master sent the servant, or the boss sent the servant to go do some work, some very important work. And then it's lunchtime. So the boss is feeding all of the employees, and that one employee that the boss sent to go do some work, he's doing the work of the boss. He's doing the work of the master. And the master appreciates that. So, you know, he's busy doing the work of his boss, doing the work of his employer. And all the employees in the meantime are eating their lunch. So what does the boss do? The boss, because that person, that servant, is out doing the work for his boss, what does he do? He sets aside some special food and a special plate for that employee or for that worker, that when he comes, he is going to be given that special attention. It's held back for him. It's preserved for him. It's kept back for him, right? They set aside a special plate for him. Why? Because he's busy in the work of his master. Similarly, the person who's so busy in the recitation of the Quran, he's so busy in the remembrance of his master. A person is busy in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will set aside special gift and a special mercy for him, because he is busy with the work of his master. He is busy with the remembrance and the reciting of the words of his master. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the tawfiq to implement this. And I will end with this, that the Quran in and of itself is the best means of islahi nafs. is the best means of purification of the heart. And with the recitation of the Quran, the example of it is like sitting in a sauna. When we sit in a sauna, the doctors mention that you're sitting, you're not doing anything else, you're just sitting inside of the sauna. What are you doing? It benefits the respiratory system, the circulatory system, the nervous system, and the entire body becomes healthy, and the entire body becomes fresh, all by just sitting in the sauna. How does that happen? You're breathing that steam, and that right purifies the lungs. And the blood flow, right, is going through the body. So that benefits the blood and the circulatory system. And it's actually relaxing the muscles. So the nervous system is benefited from that. And at the same time, what is going on, it's purging you of all the toxins inside of the body. And it's softening your muscles and the cramps. And there might be, a certain pain in the body. All of these 6, 7, 8, 9 benefits are being attained when you're sitting in that sauna, in that steam house, or in the steam room. All of that is being attained just by you sitting there. Similarly, when we're reciting the Quran, brothers and sisters, how many things? The sakina is descending upon us in the recitation of the Quran. Yani, special nur from Allah Ta'ala comes. And angels descend at the time of the recitation of the Quran. For every letter of the Quran that we recite, Allah Ta'ala gives us 10 rewards. لِكُلِّ حَرْفٍ مِّنَ الْقُرْآنِ حَسَنَةً وَالْحَسَنَةُ بِعَشْرِ أَمْثَالِهَا. For every letter of the Quran is one hasana, and every hasana is multiplied by 10. Imagine. So the angels are descending upon you, right? And sakina, the light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that increases your iman, is descending upon your heart. So while you're sitting, your iman is increasing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, you're conversing with Allah ta'ala. You're conversating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you are reciting. And you are considered from the dhakireen, and the one who remembers Allah, Allah ta'ala remembers him. And it also purifies the heart from all the sicknesses, as is mentioned, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Right? وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. It is a purification for the diseases of the heart. So brothers and sisters, when we are reciting the Qur'an, Qur'an in and of itself, for those people who are concerned with the purification of the heart and attaining spiritual elevation and attaining closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and purifying the heart from its sicknesses and from its diseases, the Qur'an in and of itself is automatically doing that. When a person is reciting the Qur'an, all of that is happening. Your iman is increasing, your sins are being forgiven, your deeds are being increased. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is remembering you with His khas rahmah, and the sakina is descending. And for every letter that you recite, 10 hasanat are being achieved. What can be more superior than that? Subhanallah. And inshallah, the upcoming nights, we're going to read more of the fada'il and the virtues of the Mubarak Quran and the blessed Quran. So let us inshallah keep this one point in mind again, that the recitation of the Quran is the most virtuous and the most superior of all dhikrs. Any of the dhikr that we can imagine, the Qur'an is the most superior to that. And the one who is occupied with the recitation of the Qur'an, right, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses him and gives him better than what the people who are asking him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a tawfiq to recite the Qur'an and to engage ourselves and occupy ourselves with the recitation of the Qur'an in these Mubarak nights and days of Ramadan.